talk a lot.
Pick a little, talk a little.
Cheep, cheep, cheep.
Talk a lot, pick a little more.
Pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little. Cheep, cheep, cheep. Talk a lot, pick a little more. Pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little. Cheep, cheep, cheep. Talk a lot, pick a little more. Pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little. Cheep, cheep, cheep. Talk a lot, pick a little more. Pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little. Cheep, cheep, cheep.
Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Her light in the morning.
I am woman, hear me roar. In numbers too big to ignore. And I know too much to go back and pretend.
Welcome to Two-Headed Podcast. This is really going to be, it's not the full second episode. I think we're going to call this part two of the first episode, or part B. We got John here again. Hello, John.
Why are you doing a B? Again?
Doing a B because we're kind of hitting some of the same subjects, so it's not like a brand new subject.
Oh, okay.
I was thinking that... I really liked the discussion I had with Jens about just like, you know, our interest in music and movies and kind of where that comes from and what we like and what we don't like. But you and I never really talked about that. I mean, you and I were talking on part one just sort of about a few little things around that. But I just thought it'd be really interesting to talk with you, especially since we grew up together and how we both kind of came into our, you know, love for music and for movies and things, how music was in our house and how movies were in our house before we really got into the hardcore stuff. So how we kind of developed into where we were. If you kind of know where I'm leading.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do.
So why don't you say a little bit and I'll add into it, but telling people like, so say for example, from when we were born, obviously I was born a little before you, but when we were born till about 1976, what was our music and movie household experience?
Well, music was like anything that that mom and dad played and grandma, you know, and it was like, you know, going to grandma's house and always hearing the Music Man and I always remember just there's just like, even with music that our parents liked, there's those songs that were catchy, you know, like
right.
Tony Orlando and Dawn or something, you know. It's like,
well, I was going to see what you would bring up, and you brought up exactly what I thought you would. And to me, I think what's kind of interesting about it is that think about the fact that, well, I was born in the mid-60s. You were born in the late 60s. So both of our parents were pretty young throughout the 60s. So I would think that a lot of people whose parents were in that age group would have really had lots of rock and roll, and probably you'd listen to the radio. But we didn't have either of those things, really, if you think about it.
Yeah, yeah. When we were young, yep, absolutely. There was no radio. Or we didn't, I don't remember listening to the radio back then.
No, and when I was thinking about this podcast, I was trying to think about, like, you, like, what you experienced and then what I experienced. But I was thinking that I seem to remember we did have a radio, but it was like a radio Dad got in Vietnam, and he usually just played, like, news or shortwave or stuff on there. And then I remember us getting a really little transistor radio, probably in like 76 or something. And then we finally started listening to like popular music. But we should list a few of the things musically that were in our parents' house that like really influenced us. So you mentioned the Music Man, which I still love the Music Man. But that was because my grandma and your grandma, too, I mean, she played the Music Man pretty much when we went down there. And that was like it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like that soundtrack.
I always wanted to hear that, you know. I always liked it.
Yeah, and, I liked it too. But you were thinking about it, it was really funny. You know, we were there like in 74 or 75, 76, and we were listening to the Music Man, you know. And then I think, like, what do you remember most clearly? I don't want to say them all, but I definitely have some in my mind. Like, what do you would say would, like, be the top, I don't know, 5 or 6 albums that we would have listened to from, like, 1970 to 1976 in our parents' house?
Yeah, basically until we moved to Tacoma, right?
Right. Like, what would you say was our greatest hits that we knew at that point in our lives?
You know, of course, the Irish Rovers. Well, Dad, there's only certain things that Dad would play, you know.
I know, like, but you say of course, but I think no one else would be like, what? The Irish Rovers.
A long time ago when the earth was green, and there was more kinds of animals than you'd ever seen. They'd run around free when the earth was being born. But the loveliest of them all was the unicorn. There was green alligators and long-necked geese, some Humpty Beckhamers and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, the loveliest of all was the unicorn.
The Irish Rovers, John Denver, Sons of the Pioneers,
yep.
Some old, you know, old country stuff, which, I have a friend that actually would play this Marty Robbins, album. And I remember that Dad would play that. Cause that I told, and now I have a copy of that.
Marty Robbins. Sure.
Yeah. He's like dressed up as a cowboy, and it's got Cool Water.
Sure.
It's got, El Paso, you know.
That town of El Paso, yep.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina. Music would play and Felina would whirl. Blacker than night were the eyes of Felina, wicked and evil while casting a spell. My love was deep for this Mexican maiden. I was in love, but in vain I could tell. One night a wild young cowboy came in, wild as the West Texas wind. Dancing and daring, a drink he was sharing with wicked Felina, the girl that I love. So in anger, I challenged his right for the...
Yeah, yeah.
I think that...
Big
I
Iron,
think that
Billy the Kid.
Sons of the Pioneers did... Cool Water too.
Yeah.
And they did I always remember the song that we thought was really funny and we listened to was the Cigarettes and Whiskey and Wild Wild Women.
Cigarettes and whiskey and wild wild women, they'll drive you crazy, they'll drive you insane. And wild, wild women, they'll drive you crazy, they'll drive you insane.
Once I was happy and had a good wife, I had enough money to last me for life. I met with the gal and we went on a spree. She started me smoking and drinking whiskey.
Cigarettes and whiskey and wild, wild women, they'll drive you crazy, they'll drive you insane.